The term long division makes it sound like a long and boring process. And if you ever had to do division the long way, it may have felt like exactly that. But the truth is that long division is not only one of the fastest ways to divide numbers without a calculator, it's also a pretty cool process when you look at what's actually going on during each step. So the first question you have about long division is probably, why wouldn't I just use a calculator? Well, you could, but we're talking about long division, so let's pretend for the sake of this video that you've traveled back in time to a village in the early pioneering days and there are no calculators. Some new pioneer families have just arrived and they're in need of a log home to call their own. The village has already cut down the trees they'll be using for the cabins and they're ready to start building. But of course, the people of the village look to you, the person from the future, to tell them how many houses they can build from the logs that they have. In total, they've got 720 logs. The village people tell you that each log cabin takes 36 logs to build. In order to know how many cabins they can build, you'll need to divide 720 by 36. To set up a simple division problem as long division, you first set a bracket that looks like this. This bracket doesn't really have a name, so we'll just call it the long division symbol. You place the divisor, which in this case is 36, on the left-hand side of the long division symbol, and you place the dividend, which is 720, inside the symbol. And we officially have a long division problem. But what do we do from here? First, we read the problem. A long division problem reads a little differently than a normal division problem, so instead of asking, what's 720 divided by 36, we ask ourselves, how many times can 36 go into 720 without exceeding 720? To answer that question, we first have to ask ourselves a series of smaller questions. The first step in long division is to try to fit the number 36 into the leftmost digit of 720. So we ask, how many times can 36 fit into the number 7? Well, 36 is way bigger than 7 already, so the answer is 0 times. It's very important that we write the answer above the digit we're working with, so here we'll write the 0 above the 7. So now that we know that 36 goes into 7 0 times, we need to multiply the divisor by the number we just wrote on the top of the long division symbol, and then find the difference. 0 times 36 is still 0, so we'll write 0 under the 7 and subtract. 7 minus 0 is 7. Next, we bring down the next digit of our dividend, which is 2, and at this point, we begin the process all over again. So the new question is, how many times does 36 go into 72 without going over? It definitely goes in at least once, but we might need to use the village scratch pad to figure out that 36 times 2 is actually equal to 72. We write a 2 above the 2, and we multiply 2 times 36 and write the answer down below. The difference of 72 and 72 is 0, so we have 0. We drop down the final digit 0 and ask, how many times can 36 go into 0? The answer is 0, so we'll write that above the last digit. How do we know we're done? Well, if we continue the process, we'd multiply 0 times 36 and write that down below, but the difference of 0 and 0 is again 0. We're just going to keep coming up with zeros to write beyond the decimal point, so the answer is 20, which means the village can build 20 log cabins with the logs they've already cut. Here are the steps of long division laid out. Some of these steps might seem pretty random right now, but if we look at why this process actually works, there's actually a lot of fascinating and elegant math happening at each point along the way. The problem was to find out how many times 36 could go into 720. If you think about it, this is the same thing as asking, how many whole groups of 36 can we take away from 720? If we hadn't been around to help the villagers with long division, they might have used a horse-drawn cart that could fit exactly 36 logs to drag 36 logs away from the pile of 720, one cartload at a time in order to solve this problem. They would eventually create 20 piles of 36 logs and have their answer, but this would have taken 20 trips using just one cart. This would look like 720 minus 36, 20 different times, which isn't a very efficient way to do math. But say the villagers had 100 carts to use. With 100 carts, they would move 100 groups of 36 logs, or 3,600 logs in one trip, if we had that many logs to move. And if they used 10 carts at a time, they could move 10 groups of 36 logs, or 360 logs in one trip. These groups of carts may not seem related to long division, but they're actually a perfect metaphor for the way long division works. Let's look at why. The first step in our long division process was, how many times can we fit 36 into the digit 7? We know that digit is in the hundreds place, so we're really asking, how many times can we fit 36 into 700? You can think of this as the villagers moving 700 logs away from the rest in order to simplify their math. But wait, you can definitely fit groups of 36 logs into 700 logs, so why did we get 0 for this step the first time around? Here's where long division gets really interesting. Because we're working in the hundreds place, when we say, how many times does 36 fit into 7? The long division process allows us to really be asking, how many groups of 136s can we fit into 700? So this is like asking, how many times does the village need to send its group of 100 carts? Remember that 100 carts that can move 36 logs each would move 3,600 logs at once. We definitely don't need to move that many logs because we only have 700 in the first place. We can't fit a single group of 3,600 logs into 700 logs, so the village should send this group of 100 carts 0 times. If the group of 100 carts hasn't come to move logs, that means that 0 times 36 logs were moved. In the long division process, we multiply 36 times 0 and write that down below. So, how many more logs do we need to move in order to figure out how many piles of 36 we can make? This is where we subtract from the original digit, 7. The next step in long division tells us to drop the next digit down, but why do we do this? Well, it helps us answer the question, how many logs are left to move? Dropping the next digit down is just a shortcut for subtracting 0 from the next digit. And we now begin the process over again. Once we've dropped down the next digit, we're officially working in the tens place. So while in long division, we ask, how many times does 36 go into 72? This is just a shorthand way of asking, how many groups of 10 36s will go into 720? In other words, the people in the village want to know how many trips their group of 10 carts will need to take to move the remaining 720 logs into piles of 36 logs each. Two trips will move 720 logs into 20 piles, and after we multiply out one last time and see that we have no remainder, we have our answer.